Hello. In this, we will solve the following problem, that is, get expression for Vx of t. And we have two voltage source, one is 2 plus 5 u of t, another one is 4 u of t, and one capacitor with half capacitor, 1 by 2 capacitance value, and inductance 4 Henry and resistor 1. Vc is marked like this and IL is marked like this. Now, what is this 2 plus 5 u of t? That means t less than 0, when t is less than 0, the voltage value will be 2. But when t is greater than 0, the voltage value will be 2 plus 5, that is 7. So it acts like a 2 volt battery at t less than 0. 7 volt battery at t greater than 0. This is 4 ut, that is when t is less than 0, this magnitude of this voltage source is 0 volt. Okay, that means it is short. Okay, so now first we will find Vc of 0 minus. So Vc of 0 minus at t equal to 0 minus, this act like a short. And this act like a open. So this Vc, it's a open circuit voltage. The capacitor act like a open circuit. And this one is short. And this voltage source is not present. It is simply a short circuit wire between the across the 1 ohm resistance. Okay. So what is the Vc of 0 minus? So in that case, Vc of 0 minus is simply the voltage across this one, and this is in parallel with the 0 ohm, so it is also short circuit. So it is essentially voltage across this voltage source. So Vc of 0 minus is voltage across this voltage source. This resistance won't come into picture because of short circuit. So it is simply voltage across this voltage source. Okay, so that is at t less than 0, its value is 2. So 2 volt is the value. And what about IL of 0 minus? IL of 0 minus, since this capacitor is open and this voltage source is not active. Okay, so it is simply no current flows through this inductor. So IL of 0 minus is 0 ampere because this capacitor act like a open. So this act like a short. So it is something like a wire is hanging here. It is not at all, other end of that wire is not connected to anywhere. Okay. So that's why it is IL of 0 minus equal to 0 ampere. Okay. Now we will write this circuit in S domain. So this one in S domain at t equal to 0 greater than 0, this value will be 7. So if you write in frequency domain, it is 7 by S, no doubt with that. And you have to replace capacitance by a 1 by SC, where C value is 1 by 2, so it will be 2 by S. So it will be 2 by S. And resistance won't change, it is 1 ohm only. And inductance should be replaced by a, I have to write here a voltage or current source, I will write it later. Similarly, I have to write a voltage or current source along with this impedance. I will do that in the later step. Okay. So this LS, the impedance of inductor is SL or LS. So what is the L? That is 4. So SL equal to 4S. And this value is 4. So 4 by S. So this will be 4 by S. Now what is pending here? I have to write a voltage or current source along with this impedance and along with this impedance. So what we will follow now here? I think a current source in parallel with the impedance will be easier in this circuit. Okay, so we will do that one. So if you see that a capacitor, you want to represent a impedance in parallel with a current source. Vs is like this, then direction of arrow mark, the direction of arrow mark, the positive, where is the positive sign, there will be it is pointing. Okay, so this arrow mark is pointing towards positive, so like this you have to write there. So it is C of V0 minus and arrow pointing toward positive. So we will arrow pointing towards positive, this is Vc, we have denoted Vc, so towards positive, so that means this should be like this. And value of this is C V of 0 minus. So this value is C V of 0 minus. And C value we know it is half. And V of 0 minus we know it is 2. So it will be 1 ampere. 1 ampere. Okay. It's a current source. 1 ampere. And what about the inductance? So inductance initial value is 0 ampere. So how we can represent inductance? If you want to represent in series with a voltage source, then minus Li0 will be in series with impedance. So in that case, I of 0 is 0, that means 0 voltage will be in series with inductance. That is nothing but a simple inductance. Or if you want to represent using this one, so I of 0 minus by S, that is what, 0. So 0 is 0 current, current source is 0 value. So that means it is simply an impedance, you will not have any current source across that. Okay. So essentially this will be only impedance 4S, it will not be associated with any current or voltage source. Okay. I think other things are correct, 4 by S. Now we can apply our nodal equations here and we can find out. Okay, so nodal equation at x, finally we need an expression for Vx of t. This time just see here, we need an expression for Vx of t, not Vc of t, we need Vx of t. Okay, so now nodal equation at x or at Vx, what is the, this current is there leaving the this node, so that will write minus 1 equal to one current or entering the current is minus 1. Okay, so that's a minus sign, or if you write here it should be plus. So minus 1 equal to entering current equal to leaving, sum of leaving currents. What are sum of leaving currents? One is Vx minus 7 by S divided by 2 by S, that is the one current, that is current leaving here. Another current will be plus Vx minus 4 by S divided by 4S. And another current, one current is leaving here, another current is leaving here, other current is leaving downward. So that will be V plus Vx by 1, or it is simply Vx. Okay, so now if you simplify this one, if you take Vx to one end, other term on the this side, so then you will get Vx is equal to 10 S square plus 4 divided by S into 2S square plus 4S plus 1. Okay, so this one can be written, you just simplify that, take a common denominator and multiply here, and you find common denominator and numerator also you multiply with the, so this term will be equal to, it is 5s square plus 2 divided by 2 everywhere, And if you find the roots of this denominator, so that will be equal to s into s plus 1 by 1 plus root 2 by 2 and s plus 1 minus root 2 by 2. Okay, or it is 5s square plus 2 divided by s plus 1.707 multiplied by s, and one more term is s plus 0.292. Okay, so we find the roots, you will get these two roots, 1.707 and 0.292. Now this one you simplify further using partial fraction expansion. So this will be vx is equal to this will be a by s plus b by s plus 1.707 plus c by s plus 0.292. Okay, so if you simplify, you will get a equal to 4, you will get, and b is 6.86, you will get 6.86. c is equal to minus 5.86, you will get. Okay, so then this vx will be equal to 4 by s plus 6.86 divided by s plus 1.707 plus c will be minus 5.86 divided by s plus 0.292. So this you can easily take inverse Laplace transform. So then it will be vx of t is equal to 4 u of t plus 6.86 u of t into e power minus 1.707 t minus 5.86 u of t and e power minus 0.292 t. Okay, so that is the solution for this problem. So how we solved? A capacitor replaced by a capacitor in parallel, impedance in parallel with a current source, its value is CV of 0 minus, and see the direction of arrow mark. And IL, since IL of 0 minus is 0, so we will not get any current or voltage source along with this impedance. Then you simply write nodal equation. So after writing nodal equation, you factor out this one denominator and use partial fraction expansion, get the values for ABC and substitute. Later you find inverse Laplace transform and you will get the required solution.